Good evening, and thanks so much for coming out to this, our first concert of our 25th season here with the Kansas City Wind Symphony. This group, yes, absolutely. We've got an exciting season planned, and you can read every single date there on the back of your program. We are opening our season with a concert themed about myths and legends. It turns out there's a lot of works that all kind of center around either telling the story of important myths or legends specific to different cultures. And this next piece that you're going to hear is about one of those myths in Japanese culture. Tanabata, I think I'm calling it right, is done every summer on the 7th night of July, and there's festivals all throughout Japan. This particular piece I heard when I was actually away this summer in Colombia. My in-laws are from there, and they moved back in March, and there was a municipal band concert, professional musicians, and they played this piece, and I thought, I need to go all the way to Colombia to hear a piece by a Japanese composer to bring it all the way back to Kansas City, United States, but I think you're going to really, really love this piece, and it tells a beautiful story very beautifully musically. After that, you're going to hear a beautiful soundscape. It's a piece, of course, but you'll have trouble singing any melodies from this particular piece because it really is just a pastiche. It's a painting in music of different aspects of the moon, and you can read about it in your program, told very artfully by the composer herself. And then I'll check in with you right after those. So we hope you enjoy 7th Night of July by Sakai and Moonscape Awakening by Joni Greene.
Thank you.
We have to let our pianist get into place, so I will steal this a little bit of time just to talk a little bit about this next piece. That was a little treat. It was very tuneful, the Sakai, that particular piece, because the next piece that you're going to hear is very untuneful. And so I explained a little bit before about how I encourage you to just close your eyes for a lot of it, and don't look at the conductor, because it's meant to sound unmeasured. It's meant to sound like you're having a dream, as it were. And I got a suggestion from a trumpet player that I work with, and he encouraged me, when I'm listening to a piece like that, to just simply close my eyes and try to picture it, because as musicians, we're so trained to follow the pulse and especially as a conductor. So I encourage you to do that in this picture that Joni Greene paints for you of Moonscape Awakening.
Thank you.
So we can't do a piece, or we can't do a concert themed myths and legends without talking about the big ones that we all know and love, the Greeks. I think they started most of them. Those Romans stole all those Greek myths and kind of, and along with those Greek gods. But the four movements that you hear, the four movements that you're about to hear will tell the story of each one of these myths. Now, I always assume that everybody knows these myths because we kind of learn them throughout as we're growing up, but in preparation for the piece and then in, again in preparation for knowing I'm going to talk about it, I reread some of these things and they're very sad. So just a reminder of what exactly is going on in each one of these things. The first movement, Phaeton. Phaeton was the son of Helios, the Greek god that drove his chariots across the sky every day. And these horses are not, I mean, it's the sun literally traveling across the sky every single day. Helios being, Phaeton being a petulant youth, begs his father, I know, I'm strong enough, I can do it, I can take it, I can take it. And after much, much back and forth, you probably have kids that have tried to convince you that they can do a thing, only to find out, well, hopefully it doesn't work out as badly as it did for Phaeton, because he takes the chariot, drives it across the sky, can't control the chariot or the horses, and crashes, thus creating deserts and tundra, both hot and cold extremes, and in creating that, Zeus strikes him down for his petulance and for his error. So, ill-fated, to say the least. The second movement, Sisyphus, tells the story of a king who cheated death twice, and Hades did not like that whatsoever, so he doomed him to an eternity of pushing a boulder all the way up the hill, and then only to have that boulder inevitably fall down, and for him to start the process over and over again. It dubs the term Sisyphusian, which is something that is both full of toil and futile in the end. The third movement is a lot more playful. I promise it gets more fun. And this is Pan, the Greek sort of god, demigod, satyr. There's a lot of different envisions of Pan, and it is a supremely playful, and if you can just envision Pan flittering between the trees of the forest and maybe hiding or playing chase with someone. The final movement that you'll hear, Pandora, tells the story of Pandora's box. And I was reminded of this. Of course, we know the Pandora's box. Almost a proto-creation myth in which the evils are unleashed in the world by her opening the box of evils. But one thing I didn't realize was that in that box, after the evils are unleashed, there is only hope that remains in the original text. Hope remains. And I think that's a very powerful thing, just to remind us that even with evil in the world, which there is always hope that remains closest to us as humanity. And that's the story of that myth. And you'll hear that depicted in this particular, that final movement of Gary Zeek's Aegean Symphony. I'm going to tell this right now, since I have you. We exist off of donations, and so I want to just give you a quick commercial, give you a quick reminder that since you're here, I would really love for you to either donate in the envelopes that you'll see in the baskets just outside of each of these doorways. We'll take cash, we'll take check. If you want to just drop your debit card into the basket, we'll figure out the PIN. That'll be fine. The other thing, though, since I know that I personally never carry cash with me, is that we are now rigged up to do online donations through DonorBox. And so if you look on the back of your program there is a QR code there that goes directly to our donor page. Or you can go to the website that's listed there on the back of the program. So if you're like me and you don't carry cash around, you can donate as little as $3 to that particular thing. But we hope you can do monthly donations, if you will. Treat it like a subscription service, which in a way it is. You're getting lots of great free entertainment. So I hope you enjoy Gary Zeek's Aegean Symphony. And again, thank you so much for coming out tonight.
Thank you. Thank you.
Again, thank you so much for coming out tonight. We hope to see you at all of the rest of our concerts. If you're feeling generous tonight, which we hope you are, please scan that QR code or go just drop something in the baskets on each of the exits. I'd love to chat with you afterwards. Thanks again so much for coming. We're going to end with a quintessential powerhouse, a workhorse for the wind band repertoire, Hindemith's March from Symphonic Metamorphosis.